What's up, you guys? It's Graham here. So today we gotta have a talk. It's not usual I'm able to plan, film, edit, and post a video within the same day, but this is absolutely something we need to address, and that would be Tesla stock. Because really, as a Tesla owner, a Tesla shareholder, and as an investment channel, I have steadily been watching the price of Tesla stock keep getting higher and higher and higher. Now, for anyone who's not aware, Tesla has probably been the number one most controversial company out there, with multiple production issues and SEC violations, but despite all of that, the stock price has continued to skyrocket despite also being the number one most shorted stock in the market multiple times. But recently, things have been even more interesting. The price of Tesla stock has increased about 80% over the last month, meaning Elon Musk is now richer than Warren Buffett. And more impressively, Tesla is now the number one most valuable car company in the entire world. But it doesn't stop quite there, because one of the reasons people are paying very close attention to Tesla right now is because it's speculated it's soon going to be added into the S&P 500. And that would mean even more demand from here, driving up the price even further. So today we're going to be going over why Tesla has gone up in value so much over the last few months, how much higher it could go from here, and what's going to happen to the stock price once and if it gets added into the S&P 500. And don't worry, this is not going to be a whole bunch of anecdotes just pointing to a Tesla stock chart with imaginary chart lines just projecting where it's going to be one day. Instead, we're going to be covering the actual statistics behind this and whether or not it's a good investment. Oh, and by the way, just for fun, I went and bought a few pairs of these Tesla short shorts for $69.420. So if this video gets 69,420 likes, I'm going to be posting a picture of myself wearing these short shorts on Instagram in front of my Tesla. That's it. All we got to do is get this to 69,420 likes, and I will go ahead and do it. And don't worry, with these short shorts, I have not skipped leg day recently. Kind of, but anyway. With that said, here's what you came for, and enjoy. So first, I'll just go ahead and answer what I'm sure everyone wants me to talk about, and that would be, what's the likelihood of Tesla being added to the S&P 500, and how much would that affect the stock price? After all, I have a feeling a lot of people are buying in right now with the expectation that this is going to be added to the S&P 500, and once it does, the sky is the limit, and people can make more money than Jerome Powell and his money printer. But how true is this, and what's the reality of that actually happening? Well, as some background, here's what's going on and why it's so important. The S&P 500 represents the top 500 publicly traded companies here in the United States. The S&P 500 index is the one that I personally hold on to. It's one of the most recommended to hold in your retirement account. And even Warren Buffett says that most investors should just go and buy an index fund to the S&P 500. The benefit of doing this is that instead of going and buying individual stocks, which may or may not do well, you could own a small piece of everything within the S&P 500 with very little effort and very minimal work. History has also shown that very few investors can actually out-earn what the S&P 500 does over a 20-year period. So that's why so many people recommend just invest in an S&P 500 index fund and that's it. And listen up, when it comes to this, index funds are big money. As of last year, half of all stock fund assets were held in index funds, working out to $4.3 trillion. And the thinking is, once a company gets added into the S&P 500, it's automatically going to have all this money thrown at it with everyone investing in index funds. That's why a lot of people think the Tesla stock is going to skyrocket once it gets added, and they're trying to buy in now before that happens. And really, in simpler terms, all it means is that $4.6 trillion is sitting in index funds. If Tesla joins that index, some of that money is going to have to go and own Tesla stock, which is going to make the price go up. So here's what it takes to be added into the S&P 500. First, it must have a market cap of at least $8.2 billion, which Tesla has by a lot. In fact, Tesla already is more valuable than 95% of the companies within the S&P 500, and if it gets added, it could be one of the most valuable companies ever added in, ever. Second, it must be headquartered within the United States, which Tesla is. Third, it needs to be at least a year since its IPO, which Tesla checks that box. And number four, the one requirement that has not been able to have been met yet is this. The sum of the previous four quarters of earnings must be positive, as well as the most recent quarter. So far, we've had three profitable quarters, with the fourth quarter being scheduled for July 22nd, which is only about 10 days from now. That means if Tesla is able to post a profit on July 22nd, it'll meet the baseline eligibility requirement for inclusion within the S&P 500, and that could mean a very big deal for stockholders. However, just meeting this baseline eligibility by itself does not mean it's automatically going to be included. There's a committee of 9 members that meets every single month to vote on and discuss which companies should be included in the index. That means at the end of the day, if Tesla does post a profit, it's going to be up to the votes of those 9 people to decide whether or not it it actually gets included. But now the real question arises. If Tesla meets its eligibility requirements, and if it's voted on to be included in the S&P 500, how much of an effect will this have on the stock price, and is being added to an index enough to boost up the price? Now, to find this one out, I first began researching stocks that have been added to an index to find out if the price of the stock went up. And then I looked at stocks which have been removed from the index to find out if the price of the stock ended up going down. Now, of course, for anyone wondering, here's what I found. Anytime a stock is going to be added to an index, it's announced ahead of time, before index fund managers can go ahead and buy it. That leaves plenty of time for individual investors and speculators to buy into the stock, hoping to make a quick profit by the time it's actually added. When it was researched, it was found that stocks actually do go up in value once they're announced to be added into an index. But once it's actually added to the index, then all of that pent-up demand slows down, the stock price drops, and then it returns to a new normal. That was also confirmed by a study published in the 1990s, which found that the announcement of a stock being included into an index fund did have a measurable effect on the stock's price positively short-term. Long-term, however, it was found that adding a stock to an index has no effect permanently on the stock's price. In fact, many of these studies show that a stock's premium for being added into an index completely wears off after about 2 months, at which point it returns back to where it was previously. And all of the research ever done on this shows that adding a stock to an index does not mean it's automatically going to see superior performance and demand over a similar stock which was not added to an index. So if Tesla does get added into the S&P 500, according to all of the research and studies that have ever been done on this, the announcement that Tesla is going to be added in is going to have a much more powerful effect on the stock's price than actually being added in. After all, Yahoo was cited as being one of the most comparable companies of its size back in 1999. And that stock went up in value 64% in 5 days between the announcement of being added to the index and actually being added to the index. And of course, as we all know, after that we had the dot-com bubble, and most of those companies ended up going down in value significantly. But some people also believe that Tesla is already being priced into being added into the S&P 500, so any sort of announcement is not going to be as shocking as, let's say, Yahoo. But that doesn't mean the S&P 500 is not going to be significant for Tesla. If it comes in at a $250 billion valuation, right off the bat, it's going to make up about 1.3% of the entire S&P 500. Meaning a portion of every single one of those S&P 500 index funds is going to have to buy into Tesla to incorporate it within the fund. But remember, once a company is added to an index, it then must actually perform. And a lot of the price going forward is going to have a lot to do with its earnings, its potential, and new developments. Otherwise, if it doesn't do well, its price is going to go down, and that means less money flowing into it overall according to the index. Now, as far as where we go from here, the results are mixed. As I'm sure we all know by now, Tesla does not conform to any standard valuation by any means. And its price is honestly a total shot in the dark as to what it's actually worth. On the one hand, we have ARK Invest, which recently raised its price target of Tesla to $7,000, which as you would expect caused a lot of people to go and rush in, driving up the price. But on the other hand, you also have those like JP Morgan, which recently raised its price valuation of Tesla to the staggering, very generous price of $295. Yeah, seriously, they think this is a $295 stock, and who knows, I mean, they might be right. Now, at that point, it's really important to understand that Tesla is quickly becoming a lot more than just a car manufacturer. They're a mix between a tech company that gathers data and an energy company that develops solar and batteries. It's pretty much impossible to value them side by side with any other automaker, which is why valuing a company like this is very difficult. Not to mention, Elon Musk has a cult-like following that will believe and support whatever he wants to do. And we also have to admit that has a bit of an unquantifiable value. Now, as for my own thoughts about where we go from here, even as a Tesla owner and Tesla shareholder, I can't help but feel like a lot of this recent run-up in price is due to the FOMO of people trying to make a quick buck rather than what the company actually has to offer. Like, I love Tesla. As soon as I got the car, I went and invested in the stock back when it was $260 a share. And even though I sold off half of my shares when it hit about $914, I'm still holding the rest, and I even bought more stocks at $935. At this point, I'm just gonna let it ride, and whatever happens, happens. Maybe it was very stupid not to buy more Tesla at $1,000 a share, and maybe it was very stupid of me to sell off at $914 in hindsight. But from the way I see it, the point is much less about being right or trying to time the perfect opportunity to buy in and then sell out. And instead, it's much more about taking the calculated risks that you feel comfortable with without being overcome with emotion, and not trying to chase profits or avoid losing money. It's about being smart with your money. It's about knowing your tolerance towards price fluctuations. It's about being okay with locking in profits, knowing that if you make that decision, that is yours to make and you gotta be okay with it. From the way I see it, the recent run-up in Tesla price has not been justified, but nothing with Tesla really is. You have to be a little crazy to want to be a part of Elon Musk's overall vision, and that's just being a part of Tesla. And really, hindsight is 20/20, and only time is gonna tell how this plays out. But this one message I just want to make very clear. At these levels, investing in Tesla at this price point is a gamble. And if you're gonna buy in, just hold with the expectation that you really believe in the company and you're gonna hold on to it long term. This is really the type of stock that's just as likely to go down in value 50% in a month as it is to go up in value 50% in a month. So if you go and buy into it, just be prepared for a very crazy ride, for better or for worse. And really, to me, it doesn't just end with Tesla. A lot of the market recently has been more about panic buying than it is about panic selling. Meaning, I think a lot more people right now are buying in because they're afraid of missing out on profits, not because of the actual value of the company. And that's something that really should be avoided if at all possible. Although overall, for anyone thinking that adding Tesla to the S&P 500 is gonna make a big difference, from every piece of research and all the studies I've ever seen published on this, it seems as though the announcement of being added to an S&P 500 does more of a difference to the stock price than actually being added to the index. And overall, about 2 months is how long it takes for that newness to wear off and for the price to stabilize back down to a normal level. Take that with a grain of salt, of course. Always do your own research and always smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. So with that said, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. As always, make sure to destroy the subscribe button and the notification bell. Also, feel free to add me on Instagram where you'll see a picture of me in those Tesla short shorts if this video gets 69,420 likes. Also, feel free to add me on my second channel, The Graham Stephan Show. I post there every single day. I'm not posting here. So if you want to see a new video every single day, make sure to add yourself to that. And lastly, if you guys want 2 free stocks, use the link down below in the description, and Webull is going to be giving you 2 free stocks when you deposit $100 on the platform, with one of those stocks potentially valued all the way up to $1,400. So if you want your 2 free stocks, use that link down below. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time.